Hello everyone, I'm Ankur Chaudhary, and in this video presentation we'll be going through the current affairs from India and across the world in the month of October 2017. This will be the broad classifications of the news that we'll be following. First is awards and honours, next business, politics, economy and finance, people in news, sports, and lastly miscellaneous. Firstly, let's take up news from awards and honours. Firstly, Ms. Gauri Lankesh, of course you would remember, Ms. Gauri Lankesh was a journalist who was shot dead in the state of Karnataka. She was posthumously awarded the Reach All Women in War, that is RAW in War, Anna Politkovskaya Award. Lankesh, age 55, shared the award with Gulalai Ismail, age 31. She is a Pakistani peace activist who has faced death threats for speaking out against the Taliban. Next, Carnatic vocalist T.M. Krishna won the Indira Gandhi Award for National Integration for the year 2015-16 for his services in promoting and preserving national integration in the country. Next, eminent critic, biographer and orator M.K. Sanu was chosen for the Matrubhumi Literary Award for 2016 in recognition of his rich contribution to the Malayalam literature. Next, rather we look at the Nobel Prize winners for the year 2017. The Nobel Prize in Chemistry was awarded to Jacques Dubochet, Joachim Frank and Richard Henderson for developing cryo-electron microscopy for the high resolution structure determination of biomolecules in solution. Next, the Economic Nobel Prize was awarded to Mr. Richard H. Thaler for his contribution to behavioral economics. So the contributions are also very important as far as your papers are concerned. Next, British writer Kazuo Ishiguro, he is of course of Japanese origin, won the 2017 Nobel Prize for Literature. His most famous novels are The Remains of the Day and Never Let Me Go. And with these novels have been adopted into popular and highly acclaimed movies. Next, the 2017 Nobel Prize for Peace was awarded to International Campaign to Abolish Nuclear Weapons, that is ICAN. It is a coalition of NGOs from across 100 countries and it is headquartered in Geneva in Switzerland. And as the name suggests, this is a coalition of NGOs working towards abolition of nuclear weapons. Next, the 2017 Nobel Prize in Physics was jointly awarded to three US scientists, Mr. Rainer Weiss, Kip S. Thorne and Barry C. Barish for detection of gravitational waves. Next, the Nobel Peace Prize in Physiology or Medicine 2017 was jointly awarded to Jeffrey C. Hall, Michael Rosbach and Michael W. Young for the discoveries on how plants, animals and humans adapt their biological rhythms so that it is synchronized with Earth's revolutions. Next, Chile, this is a country in South America. It was named the best country to visit in 2018 by Lonely Planet in its Best in Travel 2018 list, and it is followed by South Korea, Portugal, Djibouti and New Zealand. Next, Professor Hans Joachim Schellenhuber from Germany won the 2017 Blue Planet Prize for establishing a new field of science known as Earth System Analysis. Next, the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Mr. N. Chandrababu Naidu was honoured with the prestigious Golden Peacock Award in the 17th London Global Convention held in London. He was awarded the category of Global Leadership in Public Service and Economic Transformation. So, in questions like these, it is a good idea to remember in what field are, let us say, Golden Peacock Awards given. They are, of course, given in the field of public services. Next, veteran writer-lyricist Javed Akhtar was honoured with the Hridaynath Mangeshkar Award. Next, veteran actor Ms. Sharmila Tagore was honored with the 2017 Lifetime Achievement Award by PhD Chamber of Commerce for her contribution in the field of cinema. Next, US author Mr. George Saunders won the 2017 Man Booker Prize for his novel Lincoln in the Bardo and became only the second American writer to win this prestigious award. Next, we look at some important news from the world of business. Firstly, Amul was recognized as India's best FMCG. FMCG, of course, stands for Fast Moving Consumer Goods FMCG company in the food sector by the International Advertising Association. Next, HDFC Life Insurance Company launched Neo. Neo is a servicing bot or a robot for Twitter that uses artificial intelligence for customer service. So it is basically a robot answering to various customer queries on Twitter specifically. Next, HPCL, that is Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited, became the first OMC, that is oil marketing company from India, that has started marketing lubricants in Myanmar. Next, Global Payment Network Visa signed an MOU. MOU is nothing but an agreement with the Andhra Pradesh government to help transfer Visakhapatnam into India's first less cash city. So this is a move towards digitization of payment transactions. This initiative is designed to provide the foundation for the city to emerge as India's fintech valley. So this is also very important, which city in India is slated to become or planned to become the next fintech valley. So the answer, of course, would be Visakhapatnam. Next, the State Bank of India signed an agreement with Escorts Limited to finance farmers for purchase of escort tractors. Next, the HSBC appointed Mr. Jayant Rikhye as the new CEO for India operations. Next, the India Post Payment Bank appointed Mr. Suresh Sethi. He is the former MD of Vodafone M-Pesa Limited as its MD and CEO, replacing Mr. AP Singh. Next, e-commerce major Myntra launched its CSR, that is Corporate Social Responsibility initiative, in association with Union Textile Ministry to work directly with weavers and elevate their economic stature. Next, we see some important news from politics. Firstly, President Mr. Ram Nath Kovind launched the 100 crore rupees Mata Amrita Nandamai Math program, that is Jeevamritam, in Kollam district of Kerala to provide the filtration system for clean drinking water to 5,000 villages across the country. Next, a parliamentary standing committee on defense was constituted to examine the operational preparedness of the armed forces and review the accidents involving strategic defense assets. This committee will be headed by BJP MP Mr. B.C. Khanduri. Next, Ministry of Ayush, Government of India, right? Ministry of Ayush in the Government of India hosted the first meeting of BIMSTEC Task Force on Traditional Medicine in New Delhi. Now, BIMSTEC is a multilateral international group. You would do well to read more about it. It's very important. Next, Ministries of Power and Textiles joined hands under a new initiative called SATHI. SATHI, of course, is an acronym for Sustainable and Accelerated Adoption of Efficient Textile Technologies to Help Small Industries. So, the power and the textile ministries would be helping the small industries in the textile sector to adopt more efficient technologies as far as production technologies are concerned. Next, to bring momentum in skilling through collaborative efforts, the Union Home Minister, Mr. Rajnath Singh, inaugurated India's first Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Kendra for skilling in smart cities in collaboration with NDMC, that is New Delhi Municipal Corporation. Next, some important news from the world of economy and finance. Firstly, and very important, India was ranked 100th out of a total of 119 countries in the 2017 Global Hunger Index report. It is released every year by Washington-based IIFPRI, that is International Food Policy and Research Institute. Next, World Bank in its biannual economic update, South Asia Economic Focus, reduced India's GDP growth forecast to 7.0% for 2017-18 from 7.2% estimated earlier. Next is another estimate from a premier international economic institute, that is IMF. IMF is International Monetary Fund. IMF slashed India's growth forecast by 0.5 percent point to 6.7% for the year of 2017-18. Next, India was ranked 8th out of 100 countries on a list of most valuable nation brands according to Brand Finance's Nation Brands 2017 report. The list is topped by USA, followed by China, Germany, Japan and United Kingdom. Next, Bangladesh signed a $4.5 billion third line of credit. Line of credit is nothing but a loan that India has extended to Bangladesh. So it is third such loan with Bangladesh, and it will be used for infrastructure and social sector development. Next, Government of India and European Investment Bank signed the finance contract for lending €300 million for Bangalore Metro Rail Project Phase 2 in Line R6. Next, Government of India and World Bank. Government of India and World Bank signed a $200 million loan agreement for the Assam Agribusiness and Rural Transformation Project. Next, in a significant move to revive PSU, PSU is Public Sector Undertaking, basically government banks, weighed down by bad loans, the government has set up a ministerial panel led by Finance Minister Mr. Arun Jaitley to consider and oversee mergers among the country's 21 state-run banks. So as you all must be knowing that a consolidation effort is on the way as far as public sector banks in India are concerned with the merger of SBI with its associate banks. Next, the Reserve Bank of India formed a 10-member task force on public credit registry for India to improve market efficiency. The task force will be headed by Mr. M. Deosthale, former chairman of L&T Finance Holdings. Next, Madhya Pradesh emerged as the top state in terms of digital initiatives undertaken with a maximum score of 100.1 on the performance index, followed by Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh. As per the report of Coeus Age Consulting, the assessment is based on 109 key performance indicators related to policy, infrastructure and mission mode projects. So this is a privately published report, not from any government sources. Next, according to the Reserve Bank of India, revised guidelines on interest subvention scheme. Interest subvention scheme is nothing but various schemes in which certain sections of the society are given loans at discounted interest rates or reduced interest rates. So according to RBI revised guidelines on interest subvention scheme, banks will provide funds to women self-help groups in rural areas at 7% rate of interest. This type of financing will be provided under the Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, that is National Rural Livelihoods Mission, in the current fiscal year 2018. Next, the MCX, that is Multi Commodity Exchange of India, launched India's first commodity options in gold, giving stakeholders a new set of financial instruments to hedge their price risks. Next is the NIIF, that is National Infrastructure Investment Fund of India. It signed an agreement, investment agreement worth $1 billion with a wholly owned unit of Abu Dhabi Investment Authority. So basically, UAE or rather one of the Emirates, Abu Dhabi, would be investing around $1 billion in the NIIF. This fund was created to solely finance infrastructure projects in the country. Next, we look at some important people in news. Firstly, the Supreme Court of India appointed senior advocate and former additional solicitor general Amrendra Sharan as amicus curiae. Amicus curiae is Latin for friend of the court, on a petition seeking reprobe into the assassination of Mahatma Gandhi. Next, film actor and Padma Shri Padma Vibhushan awardee Mr. Anupam Kher was appointed as the new chairman of FTII, that is Film Technologies Institute of India. Next, French candidate Ms. Audrey Azoulay, a 45-year-old former French Minister of Culture, was elected to become the next Director General or the Chief of UNESCO. Next, so we have five new governors and one new Lieutenant Governor of Andaman and Nicobar. So President Ramnath Kovind appointed new governors for five states: Banwarilal Purohit of Tamil Nadu, Mr. Satyapal Malik of Bihar. Of course, Mr. Malik replaces the current President Ramnath Kovind, as he has resigned from the governorship of Bihar. Mr. Jagdish Mukhi of Assam, Mr. Ganga Prasad of Meghalaya, and Brigadier retired B.D. Mishra of Arunachal Pradesh. Of course, we have a new Lieutenant Governor of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, that is Admiral retired D.K. Joshi. He was the former Navy Chief of India. Next, the first meeting of the newly constituted Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister was held at the Niti Aayog. It was chaired by Dr. Vivek Debroy. Next, the President of India, Mr. Ramnath Kovind, presented the Lal Bahadur Shastri National Award for Excellence in Public Administration, Academics and Management for the year 2017 to Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak. He is the founder of Sulabh Shauchalay. Next, President Ramnath Kovind appointed a commission to examine the sub-categorization of other backward classes, that is OBCs. The Justice retired G. Rohini will be the chairperson of the said commission. Next, Director Kundan Shah, best known for making iconic satire or comedy Jaane Bheedo Yaro, died at the age of 69 years. Next, Ms. Nisha Biswal, a former US Assistant Secretary of State for South and Central Asian Affairs, will head the US-India Business Council. So US-India Business Council is a body which is working towards promoting economic and business ties between USA and India. Next, the Union Law Ministry finalized the appointment of a second National Judicial Pay Commission to recommend salary hikes for the 21,000 lower court judges in India. It will be headed by former Supreme Court Judge P.V. Reddy. Next, the Union Government set up a high-level committee for proper management of water resources in the northeastern region. It will be headed by Niti Aayog Vice Chairman Mr. Rajiv Kumar. Next, Rajnikant Mishra, a UP cadre IPS officer, took charge as the new Director General, that is the head of paramilitary force known as Sashastra Seema Bal, that is SSB. Next, Mr. Rajneesh Kumar, the MD of SBI, was appointed as the new chairman of the SBI for a period of next 3 years. He of course replaces Ms. Arundhati Bhattacharya. Next, a parliamentary committee has decided to examine the whole gamut of Sino-India or China-India relations, including the border situation. The Standing Committee on External Affairs, which will examine the relations between the two Asian powers, will be headed by Dr. Shashi Tharoor. He is a Congress member of the Lok Sabha. Next, Dr. Soumya Swaminathan became the first Indian to hold Deputy Director General post for programs at the WHO. Currently, she is the Director General of Indian Council of Medical Research, that is ICMR. Next, Vice Admiral Ajit Kumar P. assumed charge as the Vice Chief of Naval Staff from Vice Admiral Karambir Singh. Next, former IB, that is Intelligence Bureau, former IB Chief Dineshwar Sharma was appointed as the Government of India Special Representative to hold sustained dialogue on Jammu and Kashmir with all stakeholders. Next, eminent classical singer Girija Devi died at the age of 88 years. She is considered the queen of Thumri, right? This is important, and fondly called Appaji. Girija Devi received the Padma Shri in 1972, Padma Bhushan in 1989, and Padma Vibhushan in 2016. Next, Ms. Jacinda Ardern, the leader of the Labour Party, was officially sworn in as the Prime Minister of New Zealand on October 26, 2017. Next, Mr. Rakesh Asthana, a 1984 batch IPS officer of Gujarat cadre, was appointed as the Special Director of the CBI. Next, Professor Satish Chandra, a veteran historian of medieval India and noted educational administrator, passed away. Next, Sunny Varghese, co-founder and group CEO of Singapore-based Olam International, was appointed as a new chairman of World Business Council for Sustainable Development. Next, some news from sports. Firstly, Anupama Ramachandran from India clinched the World Open Under-16 Snooker Championship title at St. Petersburg in Russia. As far as these type of news items are concerned, well, it's not important for you to remember the name of the championship, but you must remember the sports with which each sports person is associated with. So in this case, Anupama Ramachandran is associated with snooker. Next, the 2019 AFC Asian Cup football tournament will be hosted by UAE. The winner of the 2019 AFC Asian Cup will earn the right to participate in the 2021 FIFA Confederations Cup. Next, long-serving Indian boxing coach Mr. Gurbakh Singh Sandhu was honored with the National Awards for Senior Citizens by President Ramnath Kovind. Now, Gurbakh Singh has been coaching the national boxing team for about 2 decades, and currently he is coaching the women's contingent of Indian boxing. Next, England won their first ever FIFA Under-17 World Cup by defeating European champion Spain in the final at Kolkata. Next, Ms. Pooja Kadian became the first Indian to win a gold medal at Wushu World Championship. Wushu, of course, is a type of martial art, by defeating Evgenia Stepanova in the 75 kg women's Sanda category. Next, Shamshed Khan, India's first swimmer who had participated in the 1956 Melbourne Summer Olympics, passed away aged 86 years. Next, Cristiano Ronaldo, Real Madrid's Portugal striker, was named the 2017 Best FIFA Men's Players Award for a second straight year. Next, Patna Pirates won the 5th edition of Pro Kabaddi League by defeating Gujarat Fortune Giants in the final in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Next, Indian golfer Mr. Gaganjeet Bhullar clinched the 2017 Macau Open Golf Tournament title to bag his 8th Asian Tour title. Next, Ms. Hina Sindhu clinched the 10-meter air pistol gold medal at the Commonwealth Shooting Championship in Brisbane, Australia. Next, India's hockey team won the 10th edition of the Men's Hockey Asia Cup tournament by defeating Malaysia. Next, Mr. Jackson Singh from Manipur created history by scoring India's first ever goal in FIFA Under-17 World Cup during India's match against Colombia. Next, we see some miscellaneous news items. The world's first negative emissions plant that turns carbon dioxide into stone began operations in Helisheidi in Iceland. Next, the International Day for Disaster Reduction was observed on October 13 with the theme Home, Safe Home, Reducing Exposure, Reducing Displacement. Next, the World Mental Health Day was observed on 10th October with the theme Mental Health in the Workplace. Next, the International Day of the Girl Child was celebrated on October 11th with the theme Empower Girls Before, During and After Crisis. Next, Archaeological Survey of India, Ministry of Culture, in collaboration with National Geographic Society, hosted an international conference on Dialogue of Civilizations, that is the 4th edition, in October at Delhi, Gandhinagar and Dholavira. Next, the World Animal Day was observed on October 4th. World Teachers Day was observed on October 5th with the theme Teaching in Freedom, Empowering Teachers. Next, the World Habitat Day was observed on October the 2nd. with the theme Housing Policies, Affordable Homes. So as far as the themes of these days are concerned, these are not very important, but it's very important that you remember the dates of these particular important international days. Next, the International Day of Older Persons were observed on October 1st with the theme Stepping into the Future, Tapping the Talent, Contributions and Participation of Older Persons in the Society. Next, National Center for Combustion Research and Development, the world's largest combustion research center, which will impart a major boost to the Indian scientific community, was inaugurated at IIT Madras. Next, the 5th India-Sri Lanka joint training exercise called Mitra Shakti 2017 started in Pune, that is Maharashtra. Next, the 3rd edition of India International Science Festival was held in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Next, the Union Cabinet gave its ex post facto approval to the renaming of Kandla Port as the Deen Dayal Port. Ex post facto means that the Union Cabinet has given approval after the name change has been done, right? So that is after the fact. Next, Mr. M. Venkaiah Naidu, the Vice President of India, inaugurated the 3rd International Conference on Yoga in New Delhi with the theme Yoga for Wellness. Next, Rajasthan became India's first state to incorporate skill development program in higher education. Next, President Ramnath Kovind inaugurated the 5th edition of India Water Week on October 10th with the theme Water and Energy for Inclusive Growth. It was held in New Delhi. Next, Ministry of External Affairs in collaboration with Ministry of Culture and Seher organized the first ever Asian India Music Festival at Purana Kila in New Delhi. This festival was organized to celebrate the 25th year anniversary of Asian India Dialogue. Next, tribal dominant Dungarpur district of Udaipur division was declared completely open defecation free, thus becoming the first open defecation free tribal district of the Rajasthan state. Next, for the first time, Nepal and India will undertake a joint tiger census in their respective national parks, forests and protected areas, adjoining the two countries using a globally recognized method. Next, a new global environment facility supported effort to protect the iconic snow leopard and its natural mountain environment was launched at the start of the Global Wildlife Program annual conference in New Delhi. The project is securing livelihood, conservation, sustainable use and restoration of high-range Himalayan ecosystems project. This name of the project is important, that is Secure Himalayas. It was launched by Government of India in collaboration with UNDP, that is United Nations Development Program. Next, the GWP, that is Global Wildlife Program conference was held in New Delhi. India's hosted the program jointly with World Bank and UNDP to address illegal wildlife trade across 19 Asian and African countries. Next, the 13th session of the Conference of Parties to the Convention of Conservation of Migratory Species of Wild Animals will be hosted by India in 2020. Next, the world's first hybrid electric tram powered by hydrogen fuel cells was launched in China. Next, a small country called Burundi became the first country to pull out from the International Criminal Court after a one-year withdrawal process came to an end. Next, the World Polio Day was observed on October the 24th. Next, the United Nations Day was observed on 24th October to mark the 72nd anniversary of UN Charter's entry into force. Next, the International Day for Eradication of Poverty was observed on October 17th. The World Food Day was observed on October 16th with the theme Change the Future of Migration, Invest in Food Security and Rural Development. Next, India, unfortunately, topped the list of 7 countries accounting for 64% of the 10.4 million new TB cases worldwide in 2016. India was followed by Indonesia, China, Philippines, Pakistan, Nigeria, and South Africa. Next, the National Unity Day, also known as Rashtriya Ekta Divas, was celebrated across India on October 31st to commemorate the birth anniversary of Iron Man of India, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, one of the founding leaders of Republic of India. Next, the Infantry Day was celebrated in India on October the 27th to commemorate the first infantry action post-independence. Next, India's passport was ranked 75th out of 94 countries according to the Global Passport Power Rank 2017 by global financial advisory firm Art and Capital. The list is topped by Singapore, followed by Germany, Sweden, and then South Korea. Next, the Meghalaya Election Department entered Limca Book of Records for formation of the biggest human logo comprising young voters in the state. Next, Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated the first phase of the ₹615 crore Ro-Ro ferry service between Ghoga in Saurashtra and Dahej in South Gujarat. This is the first of its kind project, not only in India but also in Southeast Asia. Next, giving the Indo-Russian Defense Cooperation a major boost, Exercise Indra 2017, the first ever tri-service joint exercise between Indian and Russian armed forces, was conducted in the Eastern Military District of Russia from 19th to 29th of October. Right, so this was the first ever tri-service in which Air Force, Army and Navy, all three took part. Next, the Union Ministry of Women and Child Development launched an online campaign called hashtag I am that woman to end gender bias in women against women. Next, India's first ever All India Institute of Ayurveda was inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in New Delhi. So that's all as far as this presentation is concerned. I hope this is helpful in your preparations. Thank you very much.